We all done that homework, CD. No, Justin did not do. I know he is smiling. Did you do, Justin? No. From his smile, I can make out. Srihari, did you do that? Srihari also not did. You did not do. I can make out from your smile. Jarlin, did you do? Adilya, did you do that homework?
Yes, ma'am.
Did you do?
Yes.
Yes?
Yes.
Did you get the answer?
Yes.
What is your answer?
90 meter.
My question was only displacement at CD, no?
Yes, ma'am. Okay.
Ma'am, 30 meter, no?
30 meter. Okay. We will check. We will check. Those who did. Anjali Priya, did you do that homework? Did you do the homework? We will check whether that 90, one got 90, other one got 30. Ashik, did you do? Say yes or no. No. Smile. Look at the smile. And I don't have to ask others. I can make out from all your faces. You all did not do. Very good. Okay. If we're going to be like that, how we will pass 9th standard? Beginning itself, you are not doing homework, nothing. And first of all, online class. Think, I have many times told you, you need to work it out, whatever I am teaching you. And you know that as compared to 8th standard, it is not easy. That you agreed, all of you?
Yes,
did you agree? So if you don't take extra effort, how can I help you? Okay. Others, do it now. So we are going back to it. CD. So those who did also check where you went mistake. Okay. So our answer is find the displacement at CD. So we only have to worried about this CD. Okay. We don't have to worry about rest of the parts. When you look at CD, you join this D. Then you are getting a triangle. Okay. You are getting a triangle. So we need to find out area of that triangle. Once you find out the area of the triangle, you will get the displacement. Because area under velocity time graph gives displacement. That's what we studied. Okay? So, what is the equation of area of a triangle?
Half into base into height.
Yes. It's a right angle triangle, half BH. Clear? Now, we only have to worry about this portion. So, what is B? B will be only between 10 and 16. Adulya, what is the value between 10 and 16? How much is the time now? Between 10 and 16, how much is the time? How to find out that, Adulya?
6 seconds.
Yes. Adulya, is that? Who said that?
Kartik.
Very good. Kartik said. Adulya, why? He said 6. We have to find out only between 10 and 16, no? Between 10 and 16, what is the difference, the time? 16 minus 10. Correct?
Yes, ma'am.
Correct? So this will give you 6. Okay. What is height, Adulya? H, you have to look at where is C? The highest point. How ten. Much corresponding?
Ten.
Let Adulya tell.
Ten.
Corresponding C. Where is C, Adulya? Look here. What is on velocity?
20.
Did you understand? We had to look at the base. base is like time, height is like velocity here. Okay, okay. So we will get the answer half into 6 into 20. So now tell me what is answer. I am not doing. Tell me. Do it and everyone do it and tell me what is the answer.
60 meters.
60.
Yes. Have you all got it?
Yes.
You can cut 216 also. It's not necessary 220. Okay. 216 also you will get 3 into 20 you'll get 60. So what is your answer?
60 meters.
Yes.
60.
Yeah.
60 meters.
Yeah, very good. So what was the answer for AB, displacement at AB? What was the answer we got?
80 meters.
Okay. What is the answer we got at BC?
40 meters.
40 meters. So look at, it's a non-uniform motion. That is, object is moving differently. That means different time. It is in different time, but equal velocity. 10, 20, 30. Equal interval is there. 10, 10, 10. But the time is changing. 4 plus 4, 8. 8 plus 2, 10. Then 10 plus 2, 4. Again plus 2. So it's a non-uniform acceleration graph. In non-uniform acceleration, every part of the body, we will get a different value. That already we calculated. What was AB? What was the acceleration you got? Previous class, we did it now. What is the acceleration at AB? What answer you got it?
2.5 meters.
Meter per second square. What was the acceleration at BZ?
0.
Why? Because it is a uniform velocity. Velocity is not changing here. That's why 0. Similarly, did you find the acceleration at CD? Did we find acceleration? Did we find
No.
Okay, that we will find later. So, displacement, you got it. So, that we will find. Next problem, we will find that. So, anyone has a doubt regarding the displacement now? So, since acceleration is changing, displacement also changing. That's what we learned it. At AB, acceleration was different. So, displacement was 80 meters. In BC, no acceleration, but there was displacement because body was moving with the same velocity in 2 seconds. There's no change. Okay. Acceleration was 0, but displacement, it covered 40 meters. Now we come to the last part. It is coming negative acceleration because body is coming back to the where it started. Just imagine this 0 can be its object house or starting point. And 16 may be the final point. Anyway, in the picture, we have not, it is not shown whether body is reaching to rest position. It is only halfway. In 16 seconds, body is at a halfway. Okay, it did not reach. If this line touch this axis, then we can say that 16 seconds, body came to rest. But in this case, we cannot say it is 16 seconds. The reason is that the body's journey, the graph only show up to here, up to 10 meters. So this is how we identify the motion. We identify the different type of motion. Clear? So in CD, the graph is coming down. That means it is negatively accelerating, means velocity is decreasing. Clear? But displacement is there. We got it 60 meters. Okay? Now, after finding all this, you can find out the total displacement of the entire journey. Entire journey means from 0 to up to 16. Entire journey can be sum of all this displacement. AB plus BC plus CD. Clear?
180 meters.
Yeah. So, write down. Those who did not write, total displacement of the entire journey. So I think question number, just put, I can't remember the which question number, 3 or 4?
4.
Okay, next, total displacement of the entire journey. Entire means full. How much the graph? That much is equal to displacement. See, this much elaborately you don't have to write in the exam. This is first time, so that's why I am writing all these steps. Otherwise directly you can write 180, whatever. This is for you understanding, because after 1 week you again open the book, that time you will not know what you have learned. Just like happened now some of you. So first is 80 plus 40, 40 plus 60. So what is your answer? Yes,
180.
This is 180 meter.
Miss, one doubt.
Yes, tell me. Ask.
The find the displacement at CD. That one. That in breadth is 6 meter.
Breadth is.
Then how height become 20?
I'll come to that point. Yeah.
Height is between 20 and 10 now.
Hello? Starting from where? This is the point. When you draw this and you join the line, you are getting. Where this 20? 10 corresponding 10 second. Corresponding 10 second, what is the velocity? That's we have to look.
Now I get it.
Got it?
Okay,
that's why. Yeah, what he has said is correct, I think so. 1 minute. You take the slope, that's correct. Sorry, it's a mistake. That is, you are taking only this much, correct? Taking is this much only. So, gradually what will happen? Height is 20. Yes. 20 minus 10, 10 only. So, just change that 10 only, correct? There I made a mistake, correct? Because this graph is not touching, so we have to think about that also. Just rectify that mistake. It's clear, because we are taking triangle only. We are taking triangle up to this portion. This is the slope. So that's what he said is correct. So our height will be 20 minus 10. That correct. So what is your answer is going to be? Then it will change.
30 meter.
So just correct it. Correct. Thank you. Sometimes we also will make mistake. So what is your answer is going to be? 80 plus 40, 120 plus 30, 150. Yeah, correct. So just correct it. All of you correct that? Can I go to next?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Next, question number 5. See, from the same thing we can find out so many things. Question can make a number of the question. Next question number 5. Find the acceleration at CD. Find the acceleration at CD. So 5 questions, 5 mark. Find the acceleration at CD. Sometimes they will give you the data. Then you have to draw the graph and find out. That also can become. If it is like that, if it is 5 mark question, drawing the graph itself, you will get 3 marks. Then remaining marks, 2 marks. So this is a pattern. They'll make you to draw the data will be given. You draw the graph and then find out. So that time you, the graph paper will be given to you in the exam. So it will be easy for you. Okay. Now find the acceleration at the CD. Let us go back to the picture again. That is clear. CD. Here CD means acceleration means V minus U by T. Tell me now what is V. So Abel, what is V? Final velocity V in CD. Yes?
10.
10, correct. Yeah, so well, you are good at max, I think.
No.
So.
No, which?
Because I have seen, you are active in when I do the max. So, I think there's a lot of
information. Ma'am, note.
I asked.
That answer.
Then who gave the answer?
Ma'am, I gave the answer.
I means who?
Lakshmi Nanda.
Ah, your video is on, Lakshmi, now. Okay, correct. So, well, Lakshmi said it 10, 10. Is it correct?
10,
correct. Why?
Yes.
Why it is 10?
Because.
Because? Where is D? Yeah. Corresponding D velocity is 10. Correct. And initial velocity, because it's a negative acceleration. Initial velocity, what is
20.
That? 20. So write down. So acceleration is equal to V minus U by T. Don't forget to write the formula. In case you make mistake with the problem, you will get half mark for it. That's equal to, you can write it down. V is 10 minus 20. And time you already know. Between 16 and 10, how much is the time? 6. So you can directly write that. I don't have to repeat again because we have done that. So your answer is?
Negative 10 minus 6. 10 by 6.
10 by 6. Now do it and give me the answer. You may get decimal. Negative should be there. Then only we can prove that it's negative acceleration. That is because smallest number minus biggest number.
5/3.
5/3. What is 5/3? In physics, there is no fraction answers.
1.4.
Minus?
Yes, 1.7.
1.7,
ma'am, because 6 is continuing, so we can round off.
Okay, okay. You will get answer like this. So you can write it 1.7. Minus 1.7 meter per second square. Okay? Any doubt regarding this? Can we move on? So, study this graph alone very well. Because I have given maximum number of questions in one graph. So, same pattern of questions can be asked. Numbers may be different. So, same type of problems I will send in the WhatsApp. Practice it and learn. Okay. Once you understand one problem like this, then any problem which come under that, you will able to do. And one more question. Let me go to the next thing. Suppose, I can say, trapezium, what is the area of a trapezium? Area of a trapezium. Tell me.
Ma'am, half into height into base one plus base two. Height into base one plus base two.
Half into height into sum of the parallel sides. Correct? Height into sum of the parallel sides. That is what we have learned. Sometimes your graph may be like that. Sum of the parallel sides. That you can write half h into l plus b. Okay. Suppose I just give you like that trapezium. Just draw this graph. I am not giving other points, only whatever points required, that only I will give you. So trapezium area, that also can come in this, in the graph. So area of the square, area of the rectangle, all these things you should be studied. Okay, that formula for just draw the next figure. So here I can give you 40, just whatever require only 20, 0. Then here I can give you 4 seconds. Other points not required. To understand this, I am just giving you this. Draw this figure. So there are some points are here, just enter that points. So actually this is not there, this will not be given, but once you get a graph like that, to find out the displacement you can draw like this. So usually whenever you get a graph like this, so graph is actually from 20 to 40, that much only, okay, starting from zero, and this we are joining only. Always in the exam it will not be given. Now my question is, find the displacement, write down, find the displacement of the entire journey. Find the displacement of the entire journey. Find the displacement of the entire journey. So this is our trapezium. So when you join this, you will get a trapezium. Trapezium means two parallel sides and opposite. This is our height. So this part turn into height. Then you incorporate max here, this will become height, and these two parallel sides will become L and B. Okay, so once you get like that, according to the values, you just substitute the values. So write down, so displacement is equal to displacement equal to area of trapezium. Write the trapezium equation, that is half h into l plus b. Half h go to l plus b. Displacement is equal to area of a trapezium, half h into l plus b. Okay. Anjali Priya, have you drawn, completed this? Have you completed drawing that, all of you? You want me to see the graph again? Yes. Okay. Gauri Priya, what is H in the figure? What is H in the figure? Tell me. So I'm writing half into area. H means how much, Gauri Priya? Look at the figure and tell me.
4.
Sri Hari. You are Gauri Priya. Anjali Priya.
Not to me, Kartik.
Kartik only. Oh, Kartik is today so much active. Anjali Priya, tell me. Kartik, keep your mouth shut.
Okay, ma'am.
Because I want to know others understanding or not. Are you saying, Anjali? 4. Okay. And what is L and B? I have already mentioned. You just have to tell me the answer. L is how much? Okay, Anjali, your audio has a problem. Okay, let me go to other one. Who is there? Geraldine. What is L? Look at the picture. Look at the graph and tell me what is the value of L here.
20.
L, where I mentioned L, L is this side. So what's that? 40. L is equal to 40. What is B?
Ma'am, how it become 40?
From 4 to here, look at here. This is our area. This is the part area. If you can't understand, just give a shaded region. With the pencil or pen, you just indicate. Area under velocity time graph means, what is that? We have to take consider all this graph and under all the area. When you look at under the area, it is a trapezium like this. It's a trapezium. So, trapezium equation is half into height into sum of parallel sides. If you look at this and this part is parallel. Now, if you consider this is L, then look at where the L is ending. L is ending corresponding value 40. Correct? This distance is 40 velocity. Velocity 40. Plus, base means this part. This part is how much? 20. From 0. 20. This is how we identified. I think you need to have a more practice. Send more problems like that. Practice it. 2 days are there, no? You will practice. Now tell me the answer. Half into?
120.
40 plus?
120. 120 meter.
120 meter. Clear?
Yes.
Yeah. So this is how to find the displacement. Suppose if you draw the graph, you get a trapezium. The figure is just like a trapezium. Apply the area of a trapezium and do it. Okay?
Okay.
Okay. So I'm ending the session. Students, just practice the same problem I give you in the class. That's enough for you to understand the concept. If you don't really study, don't say thank you. I know you want me to chase you away. You don't want to study. That's not good. You have to study. Okay. Okay then.
Thank you, ma'am.
Yeah.